Hey, it's Jared with State of Tech. Today we're going to compare the iPhone 13 camera to the iPhone 13 Pro. I have the Pro Max here, but I'm just going to call it the Pro so I don't have to say Max 1,000 times. The naming structure on these phones and pretty much all Apple products are starting to get a little absurd. But when it comes to choosing which phone is best, especially in regards to the camera, there are some things to consider. We're going to look at side-by-side comparison photos in this video, along with some video that I filmed on both of these phones as well, so that we can try and determine how much of a difference there really is between the two cameras on these phones. Now, the phones themselves have subtle differences, and so if it's not the camera that you're concerned about, really there isn't a whole lot else that's different between these phones. Yes, the build quality of the frame and everything on the iPhone 13 Pro is a little bit better than the 13. The screen refresh rate is faster, 120 hertz, versus that doesn't come on the iPhone 13. I think it's slower, 60 or something slower. But I don't notice much of a difference when using these phones for everyday tasks. I use my phones quite a bit throughout the day for my life, my work life and everything, including photography. And the iPhone 13 really is no slouch. So the phone features are really what sets apart the iPhone 13 Pro from the iPhone 13. And we're gonna do a lot of pixel peeping and looking into some images to see if there's that much of a difference between these two phones. The main differences that you will notice that are apparent is the fact that the iPhone 13 has two cameras instead of three, which the iPhone 13 Pro has. The two cameras are an ultra-wide and a standard focal length camera. There is no telephoto. These are 12 megapixel cameras, and they do a fantastic job capturing really good images. There's good detail for a smartphone camera, and you know, the images are very usable. I mean, images that I took with this phone, I was very impressed with, and I've been on the Pro phone since the Pro phone, they started adding Pro to the iPhone. And so the iPhone 13 camera definitely is enough for probably the majority of the people out there. There are some shortcomings with this camera, and we'll look into some of those as we're comparing images between these two phones. But stepping over and looking at the iPhone 13 Pro, it has three cameras. It has an ultra wide, it has a standard focal length, and then it also has now a 3x telephoto, which means you're able to zoom in on items and get closer to them without having to pinch and zoom in, which is digital zoom on the iPhone 13, which is going to result in a loss of detail in your image. And so when you zoom in like that, you are losing detail. If you have a telephoto lens, you can get closer without losing detail. Of course, the iPhone 13 Pro still allows you to zoom in beyond the 3x, which then is digital, and you start to lose detail. But at least you have another option there to get closer to whatever it is that you want to take pictures of without having to use your legs and move yourself closer. So the sensors and the lenses on this camera on the 13 Pro are a bit better as well. I noticed clarity differences in some of the images, which we'll look at together. And then also the fact that there is a different aperture, and there's some different things that show up in the settings that are represented in the photos that I took that show that this camera produces a little bit, I mean, it's set up to produce a little bit better of an image than the iPhone 13, but some of those things don't really matter too much. When it came to taking images in really low light situations, both of these phones were pretty close to each other. And so some of those things are, I don't know if they necessarily matter a whole lot. Maybe they matter a lot if you are more of a seasoned photographer and you're looking for those professional features in your smartphone. But if you're the everyday person who just wants to take decent pictures, the lines really start to blur between the iPhone 13 and the iPhone 13 Pro. Obviously, one standout difference is that on the iPhone 13 Pro, you can shoot raw images right from within the camera app. Of course, there are third-party camera apps that allow you to shoot raw images. I'm not 100% sure if those are actual raw images or if the camera app is making a raw image out of the data that it's collecting, but it now natively, and for the last couple of versions, I think you've been able to capture raw images on an iPhone and then edit those images. And when you are looking at a raw image, you have much more data to work with than an image that's been compressed into a JPEG or the high efficiency HEIF format that Apple's been using and making as the default for the last few years on the phones. And so that image compression format compresses the images. It takes out the data that it doesn't think is useful in order to show a nice looking image. And those are the details that in a raw image we can bring back when we're editing an image. For example, those underexposed areas, we can bring back some exposure in those details and bring back some areas that might have been too dark. And those areas, maybe even in the sky where things were just a little too bright, a raw image is going to have that extra data that we can pull back. So let's take a look at some images and see the differences. I think you're going to tell that there are not a ton of differences unless you really get into the finer details of the images. Let's take a look. All right, so let's take a look at these photos. I have both the iPhone 13 and the iPhone 13 Pro photos kind of side by side. I'm going to do my best to show you side by sides and explain the differences between these images. So let's start with the first image that I took, which is a side by side of the flag outside of my home. Really not a lot of differences here in these images. These two are very, very similar. You can see this is the HEIC out of the iPhone 13, and this is the DNG out of the iPhone 13 Pro. When we zoom in here and look at these two different, let's see, the tip, I guess, of the flagpole, you can see that the cameras decided to focus on different areas. This does look a little bit sharper over here on the iPhone 13, but what I refrained from doing was really like tapping to focus. I wanted the cameras just to figure out where they wanted to focus. So we'll click around and look at these images a little bit side by side. And you can see this this iPhone 13 image overall here looks a little bit better just because of the way it decided to focus. If we start to look at things over in the background, you can see there's a little bit more sharpness in the background. There's a little bit more blur in the background on the 13 Pro, which probably has to do with the sensor, the lens on the camera having a little bit wider of an aperture on the 13. And so, you know, we could bring back a little bit of the detail here if we wanted to, but I like having a little bit more focus fall off, the background being a little more blurry than the foreground. So we're not going to go into as big of detail on all of these photos, but we do want to look at the side-by-sides. These photos look very close to the same between these two. And if we zoom in a little bit here on the details, I mean, very, very similar. You might say that the 13 is a little sharper than the 13 Pro, but keep in mind this is a DNG and it's not going to have as much sharpening applied. And so I could bring back detail there and choose that detail on my own. So I might go and open this image and go over into the develop tab here in Lightroom. And I could go and, I mean, now look at this image. It's definitely a little bit nicer already. I can slide over a little bit of clarity and even bring in a little bit of noise reduction just to handle some of what's going on over here in the corner. Let me just add a little bit of exposure, maybe a little bit of contrast. Let's just mess with this image a little bit just to see if I can improve it over the image that came out of the 13. And then we'll go back and do a side-by-side comparison. I might warm this one up just a skosh. All right, now let's go back over to the library tab and we'll do a side-by-side comparison of these two images. And as you can see now, the 13 Pro image is definitely a lot nicer. And you can see the detail there is better in the letters than on the 13. And so this is what you're gonna get out of DNG raw images as opposed to the HEIC. This is a flattened image that has different elements baked in, whereas the DNG is going to give you the ability to set that on your own. So let's go a little bit further here. You can see these images look very close to the same. The DNG not as warm as this image over here on the left from the 13. But like I said, we can bring detail, bring color into the DNG image, and we have a lot more flexibility with the DNG image than we would otherwise. And so just to go in and go into develop mode and edit this image, you can see it is a flatter looking image out of the camera, but I can add a little bit to this image and make it look more appealing than what the 13 would produce on its own. And I'm not doing a whole lot here. I'm really just kind of going in and barely messing with any of these, and it's going to produce a bit nicer of an image. So now if I go back to the library tab and we view these two images side by side, this image over on the right, definitely the color and everything is more appealing in that image. So we have, this was with the night mode, it had to go to 1 second to capture this image. Those are very close to the same. It swapped them here. Let's actually see if we can, there we go. Now we've got the 13 on the left and the 13 Pro on the right. Notice that there's a little bit more clarity in the background. This image is going to be a little bit cleaner, especially after we added a little bit of an edit to it, than this image, where even we can see around the edges of the can, it's softer than on the iPhone 13 Pro Max. And so that's a better overall image that's going to give us more to work with. This image, the DNG, looks a little bit flatter. But if you zoom in here and look at the top of the can, you can see discolorization and stuff going on here, artifacting all over the edges of the can. While there is some of that on the 13 Pro, the 13 Pro image could be cleaned up further. So definitely a better image overall. Let's look at this image here side by side, and then we'll spend a couple of seconds working on it. So let me flip-flop them. We've got the 13 on the left and the 13 Pro on the right. Both of these images look decent. You can see there's a little bit more detail in the 13 Pro, whereas the 13 has a little bit more vibrance. That's definitely something we can adjust. Let's go into this image and let's adjust it a little bit. I want to make sure that we have correct image. There we go, the DNG selected. You can see here that as soon as I go into the develop mode in Lightroom, it shows me the actual image instead of the color profile in the preview image that I think Apple throws on top. And so once I come in here and start to manipulate this image a bit, it really is going to look a lot better than what I can get out of the iPhone 13 natively. And so let's just spend a few seconds working on this image, and then we'll do a comparison again. And I'm not doing much here. I'm not going down and doing any split toning or any color grading or whatnot. If I really wanted to get carried away, I'd go into the HSL and start messing with these sliders and really dialing in those colors. And that's where things really start to look good, and you can separate these colors and improve them. I can, you know, come down here and really just make some changes to the overall image that are gonna improve it. And so now if I go back to the library, there's some things over here I'd still need to fix. This image is not perfect by any means, but if I go back and view them side by side, and let's just flip them, we've got the 13 over here, and we've got the 13 Pro over here. So if we zoom in and once again look at this image at 100%, there's so much more detail in the 13 Pro. There's things that I would still clean up and adjust here. You can see there's a lot of detail here down in the ground covering, whereas on the 13, it's almost hard to tell if there's any detail there at all. So let's just spend a few more moments kind of going through, viewing some of these images side by side. Here's another good one of the sky. And so let me make sure those are in the right order. We've got the 13 over here, the 13 Pro. If we kind of zoom in down here, you can see things look relatively the same because that color profile is there. If I go and open up the DNG and the develop tab, you're going to see the colors change. And now we can really kind of see a difference between these two images, this being the 13 Pro, and I could spend a little bit of time here dialing in this image and make it just so much nicer because there's extra detail there. And yes, I can go and do similar settings adjustments like this to the photo out of the iPhone 13, but I'm not gonna have as much dynamic range to play with, and the sharpness is not gonna be there. So whereas this image is really coming alive here, and I'll just maybe add a little bit to it. I think we need a little bit of noise reduction now because these smaller sensors definitely need some help with the noise reduction. But if I go and view these side by side, this down here, these oranges, this color in the sky, way blown out, it's too much. I don't like it. The details and the clouds, I was able to kind of emphasize that a little bit here. You can see the color of the sky is better in this image. I mean, I'd still go and dial these colors in a little bit, but the image over on the right is definitely a lot nicer. And if we go down into the details here with this cable coming through here, and even these lines that are coming through, there's more detail here in these areas. And that's what really stands out in a camera like this, is the improved detail. Let's take a look at the differences with the video. All right, so what we have here is iPhone 13 video on your left and iPhone 13 Pro Max video on your right. And so the top two videos are the rear-facing camera, the bottom two videos are front-facing kind of selfie camera, just to give you an example. And these are unedited, they're straight out of camera, and I've tried my best to really look at these closely, zooming in, but it was a little hard to film that and show you exactly what I'm looking at. So things that I'm noticing in the top left video, which is iPhone 13, and the top right video that's 13 Pro, is that the 13 Pro has some sharpness improvements in the bottom corners of the video. And so as you get out to the outer edges of the video, the 13 Pro is a little bit sharper. Also, if you look down the road a bit or down at items that are things that are further in the background, I do notice improved sharpness and clarity. Things aren't blending together as much in the background of the iPhone 13 Pro. If you look at the sky up at the top left hand corner as the sky comes in, that can be sometimes a problem area, especially as the phone is trying to expose for things that are more in the shade versus things that are in the sky. There doesn't seem to be a ton of difference, but there does it does look a little better on the 13. And when I blow these videos up, I can tell a difference. Now, if I'm looking down at the videos at the bottom, which are selfie camera, both look very much the same. I don't know if there's really any difference between the selfie cameras on either of these phones. Highlights are blown out in the background. There isn't a whole lot of detail. You can see the image stabilization maybe looks a little bit better on the 13 Pro, but I'm not really too sure. It was very hard for me to sync these clips up so that we can view them all like this. And so I don't think that there's much of a difference between the front-facing cameras on either of these phones. But the Pro features, there's nothing Pro about a front-facing camera on pretty much any device out there in the world. So really it's just comparing the top videos and seeing what image stabilization looks like. You can see it looks a little bit smoother on the iPhone 13 Pro Max over on the right-hand side. And then just the clarity differences. And all of these are set to the same settings. Everything is set consistently between these two phones, the only difference being the cameras and the way that these phones are processing that image. So I hope that this kind of helps you see the difference between the two. Not a whole lot in the grand scheme of it all, but when we get that ProRes, maybe that will be the difference maker right there. All right, so I hope you enjoyed that side-by-side comparison of the images that I captured with both of these phones. I tried to get exact copies of the image or get it as close to possible so that we can see the differences there. But, it is a challenge to get the exact same image. But in those details, really, you have to look close to find the differences in these images. Are you going to be a person who wants to go in and edit images and pull a lot of detail and things back that you typically would do if you were a photographer using a camera like this? If you're wanting that kind of flexibility out of your smartphone images, then I think the iPhone 13 Pro or Pro Max is exactly what you're looking for. If you're wanting a phone that is, you know, decently priced, it's higher priced, but it's a decent price phone, the iPhone 13, and you just want something that's going to take the occasional good picture, you don't have to worry about it. It's a simple tool that you know you can count on. The iPhone 13 is going to be plenty of phone and camera for you in a smartphone. The only time that I recommend jumping up to the iPhone 13 Pro is if you want the telephoto lens, if you want the ability to shoot in RAW, and you want the ability sooner or later to shoot in ProRes video, which is going to be a higher format of video capture for the smartphone. It's going to result in very large file sizes, but hopefully when Apple adds that functionality in the next month or so into the iPhone 13 Pro, that it does produce fantastic, very flexible video files, just like shooting in a RAW format for photos presents a more flexible image that you can do more with. So I hope that this video helped you decide on which phone that you can get. I apologize for it being a little bit longer of a video, but I think that you will see that there are strong use cases for an iPhone 13 and an iPhone 13 Pro. It really just comes down to how you're going to use the phone and the images that it captures when you take them. So if you have any questions or any thoughts, let's share them down in the comment section below. Click on the thumbs up if you like this video and subscribe to the channel so that you can be notified when I put out new videos. And until then, I hope you're having a great day and we'll see you in the next one.